morning to one and all. So last class we discussed about, so what does mean by resting potential, action potential, polarization, depolarization and repolarization. So this is a diagram shows the action potential and resting potential. So what does mean by resting potential means, if a cell is in resting state, so that is called resting potential. So polarization, it's nothing but if the cell is in resting state, na, that states that polarization. So if a cell make a movement, so the action will be a start. So it is nothing but action potential. So the states is repolarization. Again the cell will come to original state, means that is called repolarization. This block diagram shows the depolarization, repolarization and repolarization. So this slide shows the polarizable and non-polarizable electrodes. So we have two types of polarizable electrodes. One is perfectly polarizable electrodes. So the next one is perfectly non-polarized electrodes. So in the case of perfectly polarizable electrodes, electrodes in which no actual change across the electrode-electrolyte interface when a current is applied. The current across the interface is displacement current and the electrode behaves like a capacitor. So capacitor is a charging and discharging device. So over potential is due to concentration, example platinum electrode. So in that case there is no energy, it has energy, it need energy to make a transition. In the case of perfectly polarized electrodes, we need energy to make the transition. So perfectly non-polarizable electrode means electrode in which the current passes freely across the electrode-electrolyte interface. So requiring no energy to make transition. So already I specified, perfectly polarized electrode means have a energy, we need energy to require the transition. So in the case of perfectly non-polarizable electrodes, we need not to require energy for transition, to make a transition, no energy to make transition. So these electrodes are called perfectly non-polarizable electrodes. Example AG-AGCL electrodes. So AG-AGCL electrode is used in recording, while PT is used in stimulation. So this slide shows the chemical reaction. So that is silver-silver chloride. So here we are having two metal AgCl chloride metal, that is silver-silver chloride metal. So here we are using one semi-permeable membrane in between these two metal. So one metal having positive ions and another metal having negative ions. Suppose we are applying the current, means the movement of electrons and current, electrons and holes will make a movement, it will produce the current. So this is a chemical reaction of this AgCl chloride electrode. So this here K plus Cl minus is act as a interface, that is potassium chloride is act as a interface, that is potassium chloride solution is filled with it electrode. So this is a surface of the silver-silver chloride electrode. So here Ag metal is having, and then insulation and lead wire is there, and in outer side is coated with Ag plus and Cl minus surface layer, and the electrode containing Cl minus, that is negative ions, that is chloride ions. So this is a electrode behavior and circuit models, that is electrical basic equivalent circuit of electrical model, that is equivalent circuit for this AgCl electrode. So the advantage of AgCl electrode is low noise and the characteristics of an electrode is sensitivity, current density, waveform and frequency dependent. Okay, so the advantage is low noise And the characteristics of an electrode is sensitivity to current density, waveform and frequency dependent. So this metal and electrolyte. So metal has positive ions and electrolyte has negative ions. So we are applying the electrical current. So in that circuit means the positive and negative ions will make a movement, that is electrons and holes will be make a movement and it will produce the current. So that current will pass through the electrode. So this is the equivalent circuit of this electrode. So this is a skin interface. This diagram shows the skin interface. So here transparent electrolyte gel containing Cl- is used to maintain good contact between the electrode and the skin. So here there is a good contact between the electrode and skin. So this is very safe in our body. So the electrode skin interface. So this is for 1 cm square skin impedance reduces from approximately 200 kilo-ohm at 1 hertz to 200 ohm at 1 megahertz. Okay. So here your body surface electrode is placed against skin showing the total electric equivalent circuit obtained in this situation. It means body surface electrode is placed against skin. The total electrical equivalent circuit obtained in this situation. Each circuit element on the right is approximately the same level at which the physical process that is represents would be in the left hand diagram. So this slide shows the motion at phase for electrode. So when polarizable electrode is in contact with electrolyte, a double layer of charges forms at the interface. When polarized electrode means we need energy to make a transition. So that is called polarizable electrode is in contact with an electrolyte, a double layer of charge from at the interface. Movement of this electrode will disturb the distribution of the charge and result is a momentary charge in the half cell potential until equilibrium is reached again. So motion at phase is less minimum for non-polarizable electrodes. Motion at phase is less minimum for non-polarizable electrodes. So signal due to motion has low frequency, so it can be filtered out when measuring a biological signal of the high frequency component such as EMG or axon potential. However, for ECG, EEG and EVOG, whose frequencies are low, it's recommended to use non-polarizable electrode. So to avoid signals due to this motion at phase. So thank you. So the next class we'll discuss about the electrodes types.